User Interface Design, Subject Code 17CS832. Module 1. So in Module 1, we have topics like Web User Interface, its popularity, characteristics and principles, and also we have differences between Web User Interface and Graphical User Interface. So let us move on to next slide. There is an important question in this particular chapter, that is difference between GUI and web page design, or graphical user interface and the web interface. Okay, so GUI and the web interface design has certain familiarities or similarities. Okay, both are software designs, they are used by people, they are also interactive, and in both of the cases we have heavily visual experience presented on the screen. They are composed of many similar components. So if you see here a particular example of a user interface, how a user interface for a particular PC looks like. Okay, you have icons here, and you have drop down menus. If you are using drop down menus, then you may have drop down menus also. So this is an example for user interface for a PC. Okay, this is not a web interface, this is a graphical user interface for a PC. Another example we have, that is a web interface. Okay, so here one of the example, the first example you can see here, this is a web interface of a Google Drive. Okay, see how a Google Drive looks like, and they have designed it, okay, using some language they have designed this particular web interface. Okay, so thing is, in GUI, when you are using a graphical user interface, user hardware variations will be limited. That means, for example, when you are using a graphical user interface on a particular PC or a laptop, okay, users hardware variations will be limited. That means there won't be much of the variations when they are going to design a graphical user interface for a particular hardware unit. Okay, the underlying hardware variations will be very limited. But whereas if you see here a web interface, for example, this can be displayed in many number of devices. User hardware variations will be enormous in this case. See, for example, the particular Google Drive web interface can be displayed on a desktop or on the laptop or on the tablet or on the normal mobile phone, is it? So that's why we say that web interface has enormous hardware variations. Okay, the screen appearance will be influenced by the hardware that you are going to be used, underlying hardware. Okay, maybe for a laptop, the screen or the display will be very, very good. Is it for a normal mobile? Okay, it may have its own limitations for the hardware. So this is a web interface example for a web interface. The web user interface. So actually the web user interface or World Wide Web we are using since 1990s. It was the main communication medium mainly for the scientists and researchers, and it has been spread widely into businesses, organizations and homes around the world. Okay, the web interface is the design of navigation and presentation of information. So it is also about the content, not the data. Actually what you get from the web user interface is the information. Okay, there is a difference between information and the data. So if you have data in your hand, then you can form it into a information, is it? So web interface design is the design of navigation and presentation of information mainly. it is displaying the information. It is about the content. So from the information you are going to get certain contents, okay? And the proper interface design should be properly balancing the structure and relationships of menus, content and other linked documents or graphics. Okay, so when you are seeing a particular web interface, for example, you have seen a Google Drive interface. Okay, it is well structured. It will have certain relationship between the menus. Okay, and it in the menus you will be having certain contents and also the required documents are also placed inside the web interfaces. Okay, the design goal is to build a page with menus and that feels natural and is well structured and easy to use. So whenever you build a web interface, it has to be having certain menus and it has to be well structured and also it has to be very useful for the user. That means it should be a user-friendly web interface. The web is a navigation environment where people move between pages of information. The web interface is not an application environment. So it is mainly a navigation environment where you can move between the pages. So when you are searching for an information, maybe you are searching for a laptop. So the different kinds of laptops will be displayed on the web interfaces, is it? So when you are clicking on a particular link, that link will forward you to a next page. So that's called navigation environment. It is generally graphically rich environment. A web interface will be a graphically rich environment. And web interface generally provides number of links, visible navigation buttons, which will be displayed on the screen. So generally browser navigation is mostly confined to back and forward concept, but back to where and forward to where is often unremembered or unknown for the users. Okay, so there will be number of links provided to the destinations which are unknown, and also there will be invisible navigation buttons that are laid, and also these unrecognizable, there will be unrecognizable on the screen, and also there will be jumps linked to certain paragraphs. Okay, so there will be multiple number of problems in the web interfaces. Okay, web interface design is now struggling to recover from the giant steps whatever it has taken. Okay, web interface is now more difficult to design because availability of various types of multimedia and the desire for many designers to use something simple. So that means here, generally when you are designing a web interface, it has to be fitted to every kind of device that user might be using. Okay, he might be using a desktop or a laptop or a tablet or your iPhone or a normal Android phone. So this web interface has to be fitted to every kind of environment. Okay, so that will be very difficult for the designers to understand what hardware he might be using, underlying hardware he might be using, what are the tools he might be using there within his system. Okay, so this is very difficult to understand. Today, the web interface is a victim of its poor foundation. It is also victim of explosive and haphazard growth. And generally, when you are saying the web interface, it was used since 1990s, is it? After that, it has seen very highest growth, and the knowledge of users and their needs will be also expanding. Okay, in future also it may expand. Is it? The knowledge of users and their requirements also increases day by day. Okay, but the ultimate goal of a web designer is to have a well-structured design, and it also has to be very easy to use. Finally, a user might be expecting from a developer to design a web interface such a way that it should be well structured and it also has to be easier for a or user friendly application. Okay. Popularity of web. Web interface allows millions of people across the globe to communicate, access information, publish, and also to hear certain voice from the other people. It also allows people to display web pages. The main aspect of the web interface is to change the color or the graphics whenever the user needs. The decisions can be made whether or not to transmit certain data over channels. So there are a lot of uses of web interface. If you see the popularity of web, you can understand by certain data here. Okay, in 1980 or 1984, they started using web. Okay, in 1984, it was only 1,000 users. Okay, there were only 1,000 users around the world. In 1987, it raised to 10,000, and in 1989, there were 1 lakh users around the world. In 1992, it exceeded 1 million. So you can see the expansion of growth rate of the internet. Is it? So there are number of advantages of web. There are also certain disadvantages, but more number of benefits we get it from the web usage. Let us move on to next topic, that is graphical user interface versus web page design. Graphical user interface and web page design do have similarities. Both web page design and the graphical user interface are software designs itself. And if you see, both are used by people, both are interactive. And if you see the visual designs, both are having very good visual designs, and most of the things are very similar. Okay, but still we have certain differences here between graphical user interface and web interface. The first point here is, let us take device. In terms of device, if you are seeing, graphical user interface has user hardware variations. Okay, hardware variations are limited in case of graphical user interface, whereas the web interface, if you are using, user hardware variations are enormous. User hardware characteristics are also well defined in case of graphical user interface. The screens appear exactly as specified. So the first point says that the graphical user interface is having the limited hardware variation, and hardware characteristics are also well defined before developing graphical user interface, and screens appear exactly as specified. For example, when the graphical user interface was designed for the Windows 10, they had taken certain minimum requirements of the hardware. So you say you know that Windows 10 will not be installed in the older PCs or the old systems, is it? It will have its own hardware limitations. Windows 10 has to be installed in certain hardware itself, is it? It cannot be compatible with the other old systems. So that is the main thing here. The screens has to be appeared on the screen as specified by the developer. Okay, it cannot be changed. So next thing is, if you are seeing the web interface, the user hardware variations are enormous. Screens appearance influenced by the hardware being used. So that means web interface, when you are using, it may be used on a PC, normal PC, or your laptop. Some may be using mobile phones. or sometimes kids may be using tablets. So there are variations in the hardware, but that web interface has to be displayed properly in every device. Okay, it may be if you are using a Google browser, okay, it will be displayed in a laptop in a different manner, or in a mobile phone it will be displayed in a different manner. But it has to be displayed without any changes there, is it? So this is the main thing here. That is, first point is devices. Next is user focus. GUI systems are well defined applications and data, and they also have transactions and processes. And in case of web, web is about information and navigation. And environment where people move back and forth is in an unstructured way among many pages of information. So actually, user focus means here GUIs will be designed for a particular application, okay, with certain data. But whereas your web interface will be mainly designed for providing the information and navigation facilities. User may be going back forth for searching certain information. And next point is data or variable information. GUI data is typically created and used by known and trusted sources. People in users' organization are reputable and reliable companies and organizations, the data will be used. The properties of systems data are generally known. But whereas if you are seeing web interface, web is fully unknown, it will consist of fully unknown content that is placed there by others, which are unknown to the users. Okay, so if you are seeing a graphical user interface, it is typically created and used by known and trusted sources. And here, typically it is placed into systems by the users or known people and organizations. So when they are going to develop a graphical user interface, they will be the developer will be knowing who is using the graphical user interface. There will be known users or known organization. Okay, who is using the data or who is using the system, everything will be known by the developer here. But whereas in the web interface, it's all unknown. There will be unknown contents. Okay, so the source is always it's not trusted. Okay, number of organizations will be using the web interface. Privacy won't be there in certain cases. So there will be lot of problems when you are using web interface here. Okay, so next thing is user tasks. GUI system users install, configure, personalize, start, use and upgrade the programs in their system. They open, use and close the data files as and when they are needed. Fairly long times are spent within an application, and people become familiar with many of its features and its design. Whereas in web interface, web users do things like linking to the sites, browsing or reading pages, filling out the forms, registering for the services, participating in transactions and downloading and saving the things. Okay, so mainly here, what kind of user tasks will be performed in case of GUI, you have to understand. Generally, when in the graphical user interface, user may install, configure, or he may upgrade the programs like in a normal laptop, whatever the things you do, your personalized laptop, is it? So you may close as you need, when you may open the file, close the file, everything will be doing it, is it? But in case of web interface, this thing is different. You may be linked to the site, okay? You may have to start reading from the web page. If you want to fill out the forms, you can do it, filling of the form. If you want certain services from the web page, then you can register for the service. Movement of pages, between the pages and sites, will be very rapid if the internet connection is very good, and there will be familiarity with many sites that are not established. Okay, familiarity with applications are often achieved. Fairly long times will be spent within an application. So here, when user will be using a graphical user interface, he will be spending much of this time for using a particular application. Okay, he will spend lot of time there in one single application. But whereas in web page, what happens? They may be linked to other sites. One site he will be browsing, again it will be linked to other site, it will be moving to a next web page. So that case is different. And next is user's conceptual space. In graphical user interface, the user's conceptual space is controlled by the program and application. Okay, the user's access to data is also constrained, and the space is made available where their data can be stored and managed. Web user space is infinite and generally unorganized. So when you compare the user's conceptual space, it's the conceptual space means the, maybe you say a laptop here, is it? You are using the graphical user interface thing. So the space given for the graphical user interface will be all controlled and constrained by the program. It's all dependent on the hardware or software you are using there. But in case of web interface, things are different. User space will be also infinite in case of web interface. And next is presentation elements. What you see exactly on the graphical user interface? You may see windows, menus, controls, status, toolbars, messages, and so on. Okay, many transient, dynamically appearing and disappearing many elements will be dynamically appearing and disappearing based upon the current context of interaction. Okay, so that's all controlled by you here in graphical user interface. Whatever you want to display dynamically, or whatever you want to close, everything will be controlled by you. It is the graphical user interface will be presented as specified by the designer. As you know, the Windows 10, when they have developed the graphical user interface, it is presented same as it is in any other laptops if you are using. Okay, it will be same as specified by the designer. So generally standardized by toolkits and style guides. There will be standards for designing the toolkits, and also there will be style guides used when designing the graphical user interface. But whereas in web interface, web systems generally possess two components mainly: browser and the page. Okay, within the page, any combination text, images, or audio video and animations will be done, will be displayed also. Okay, and if you are seeing within a page, however, any combination of text, images, audio, video, and animations may exist. And complex, cluttered, and visually distracting pages are easy to generate and often exist. This occurs because many designers have focused on implementing that which is new, pretty, and attention-getting with little thought of given to usability. So when developing a web interface, they don't think of usability. They will be thinking how to grab the attention of the user. Okay, they will be focusing on implementing what's new, what's pretty, everything. Okay, so but all these web designs will be little standardized. There are a few more differences between graphical user interface and web interface. Next point is navigation. Navigations will be through menus, lists, trees, dialogues, and wizards in case of graphical user interface. Okay, you may have open, okay, cancel buttons in case of graphical user interface. The graphical user interface design do not provide a strong sense of navigation. Okay. So here, it is all constrained by the designer and generally standardized by toolkits and style guides. So while designing a navigation to navigations, there will be standardized toolkits and also style guides. Whereas web users control their navigations through links, bookmarks, and typed URLs. Navigation is significant and highly visible concept here with few constraints. Okay, the so he might think the few constraints frequently causing the lost sense of place. So in case of web interface, while using the web pages, generally you may not be knowing. So you click on the link, think that you are browsing, start browsing. Okay, you click one link and you will be forwarded to next page. And again, there will be again one more page opened. And again, you start to click there. And you may be forwarded and you may not be knowing from where you have or where you are right now. Okay, the sense of place will be lost in case of web page. So there are web navigation has few standards beyond the browser's back button and underlined links. It has only few standards in case of web design. Few standards means there is no restriction on how a web page has to be designed. Okay, you may be provided with buttons, links, everything. So next is typically it's a part of page design fostering lack of consistency, and it usually causes the users to be confused. So typically most navigation is a part of page design itself. Okay, it may lack consistency and it also causes the users to confuse. And next thing is context. GUI systems enable the users to maintain a better sense of context. Paths are restricted and multiple overlapping windows may be presented and be visible, enabling the users to remember how what they are doing fits into the overall task picture. Okay, in here there will be restricted navigation path, multiple Weavable windows may be present here. In case of web interface, there will be poor maintenance of sense of context. Single page entities will be displayed, and unlimited navigation paths and conceptual clues become limited or are difficult to find. That means in web pages are single entities without almost unlimited navigation paths. They don't bring up separate dialog boxes to ask questions, provide or request supplemental information, or present a message. Interactions such as clicking menu choices, pressing buttons, selecting list choices, and copy paste occur within the context of active program. So how this is going to interact in GA, and basic interaction in case of web interface that changes the so extreme changes in context which may not be noticed. Okay, in GUI interactions, it consists of clicking the menus, pressing the buttons, selecting choices from the list, keying data, and cutting, copying, all those will be seen. Okay, next is response time. Response time will be nearly instantaneous, but in case of web interface, it may be quite variable depending on the transmission speeds, page content, and so on. Long times can upset the user. So that means this, when you are using a web interface, it may be depending upon the network you are using, or transmission speeds we say. It may be varying with the number of devices. It may not be constant. If web page, generally if it opens very slowly, then it may upset the user. Okay, and next is visual style. In visual style, it is typically prescribed and constrained by toolkit here in case of GUI. Visually creativity allowed, but it will be very difficult. Little significant personalization. Okay, there will be little opportunity exist for the screen personalization in case of graphical user interface. You cannot go for changing your graphical user interface as you wish. There will be certain limitations here in case of graphical user interface. But in case of web interface, if you see, it fosters more artistic, individual, and unrestricted presentation style. Complicated may be differing browsers and displaying capabilities and bandwidth limitations. So there may be certain changes due to browser and displaying capabilities, and also bandwidth limitations. But as you know, web pages generally will be more artistic, individual, and unrestricted presentation styles will be there. For example, if you open a Gmail account, okay, interface you have there. You can personalize your Gmail account with number of colors, or background color you can change. So it presents a more artistic manner. Next, you have system capability. So GUI system capabilities are only limited in portion to the capability of hardware in terms of speed, memory, configuration, and sophistication of the software. So here, your graphical user interface may not be dependent on the speed, memory, configuration of the software what you are using. Whereas in a web interface, it may be constrained. It may be limited, and here constraints are imposed by the hardware, browser, software, client support, and user willingness to allow features because of the response time, security and privacy concerns. So here in case of web page, it's limited by the system capability will be limited by the willingness of the page owner. Okay, whether he has to provide certain functions, what security he needs, privacy issues, everything will be counted in case of web interface. But here in graphical user interface, generally the user will be a single user. There may not be certain security issues here. Okay, unlimited capability will be provided with sophisticated hardware and software of a system. So next is task efficiency. GI systems are targeted to a specific audience normally performing a specific task. They know, the graphical designers will be knowing who is the audience here, who are the users. They will be targeting the users and they will be developing the graphical user interface what they want to develop. Okay, it's only limited by the amount of programming undertaken to support it. Generally, the efficiency of performing a task in graphical user interface is only limited by the amount of programming undertaken to support it. And next you have the web interface. Browser and network capabilities limit the web task efficiency. The actual user audience is usually not well understood. So in case of this kind, in web interfaces, you will be having an audience, unknown audience, you can say. Actual user audience will be not well understood. Websites are intended for anyone and everywhere. Okay, they can use the interface, web interface. Anyone can use and any, everywhere you can use a web interface. The consistency. Consistency in graphical user system design is a major objective in most of the development environments. So if you see here, first major objective exists within and across the applications. It is the graphical user interface is aided by platform toolkit and design guidelines. As you know, there will be platform toolkits to design, and also there will be guidelines for designing the graphical user interface. So there will be consistency normally. So universal consistency in graphical user products generally created through the toolkits and design guidelines. So as you know here, the main thing is there will be consistency, universal consistency in graphical user interface products. Because it is used or designed using the toolkits and some of the guidelines. But whereas in case of web interface, sites tend to establish their own identity. They will be having their own identity. Frequent standards set within a site. Okay, standards will be different. They won't be following certain standards. So frequent ignoring of GUI guidelines for identical components, especially controls here. So that means in web page design, a heavy emphasis on graphics and lack of design standards will be there, and it is desire of websites to establish their own identities. It results in very little consistency across the sites. So there won't be much of the consistency across the sites in case of web interface. But in case of graphical user interface, they will be maintaining certain consistency because they are following certain guidelines here for developing a graphical user interface. Next one is user assistance. Integral part of most systems and applications. If you see graphical user interface is an integral part of most of the systems and applications. If you don't have certain GUIs, you may not be able to work with your systems. It is accessed through standard mechanisms. You may have documentation both online and offline. That's already all provided. Personal support desktop also usually provided. Okay, so that means user assistance is an integral part of the most of the system in case of graphical user interface. Graphical user systems applications. So for example, you say F1 key, help menus, all these are needed, or they are the integral part of the system. So you can get help from the graphical user interface to use these function keys, is it? And message and status areas are also provided in case of graphical user interface. But in case of web pages, it does not provide any similar kind of help systems. The little available help is built into the page. Customer service support, if provided, oriented to the product or service that is being offered. Okay. When you compare with the graphical user interface and the web interface generally do not provide certain help facilities. Help may be provided for the product or the service they are going to offer, but not to the web interface here. But in case of graphical user interface, you may be provided with the support desk. Personal support desk will be always provided in case of graphical user interface. And in case of next point is integration. The primary goal of most of the GUI applications is integration of all pieces. Okay, common functions are supported across the applications. Important export capabilities are also existing there. So here, integration. Here in case of web interface, it is apparent for some of the basic functions with most of the websites. The sites tend to achieve individuality. So it's distinction rather than integration. So that means here web interface, when you are saying the websites all has its own identity. So you cannot integrate two or more website into an individual website. So web page design, some integration is apparent with the site for basic functions such as navigation and printing. And next is security. It's tightly controlled proportional to degree of willingness to invest resources and effort in case of graphical user interface. It's not an issue for most of the home PC users. So graphical user interface will be more safe because they will be usually used by single users here. Okay. And in case of web pages, it is renowned for security exposures. As you know, every day there will be a lot of viruses that is downloaded through the web browsers. Okay, browser provided security options typically not understood by the average users. When employed, they may have function limiting side effects. So there will be a lot of security exposures in case of web interface. Okay. And next is reliability. Like security, reliability in GUI systems is established and controlled in proportion to the degree of willingness of the organization to invest resources and effort. The computer being used influences reliability, as does, if applicable, it's the local area network. So if you are seeing a web interface, it is susceptible to disruptions caused by the user, telephone line and cable providers, internet service providers, hosting servers and remotely accessed sites. Okay, so if you are saying reliability, here in graphical user interface, it's tightly controlled by the business systems. Okay, so whether there will be a degree of willingness to invest on the resources and effort. So all these will be taught before designing a graphical user interface. Whether to invest on the resources or whether to spend the time for designing the graphical user interface, all this will be decided here. Okay, it's all dependent on the organizations who are going to build the graphical user interface.